Hello, 大家好，我是小 Marguerite and welcome to my little Cantonese corner. 今日2020年7月23号星期一。Today it is Monday, the 27th of July, 2020, and today kind of marks my 6-month anniversary of being in the United States. I'm still waiting to get back to Hong Kong, and I actually have never lived in the United States this long since about 1989. So it's been wonderful. We've been quite busy the last few months moving house and doing a few other things. And so that's been taking some time, but now I'm back and hoping to post more frequently for you guys. So those of you who are here wanting to learn Cantonese, let's get this started first. I thought one way that I can help you guys on my YouTube channel, as opposed to those of you who are joining me over at cantolingo.com, where I have some online lessons. So if you are interested in learning Cantonese more formally with me, check it out at www.cantolingo.com. And those of you who are with me, thank you so much. But for those of you who are just here watching on YouTube and for whatever reason, for learning Cantonese, I want to do something a little bit different. And that is, because I've been here for 6 months, I haven't really been speaking a lot of Cantonese, as you can imagine. Although we could speak it at home here, we tend not to, which is kind of bad. We really should force ourselves to speak Cantonese. But I haven't been using it a lot. And you know the saying, use it or lose it. So I'm thinking, okay, let me have a go at speaking Cantonese about random stuff that's going on. And I'll take a break and in between and kind of explain different maybe grammar, sentence structure, or tonal differences or something. And in that way, you guys can have a chance to listen to more Cantonese spoken by me, and also learn a few things along the way. And those of you who are native speakers who enjoy watching my channel, you guys can listen. And if there's something that you think I could have said better, that I've said incorrectly, that you have more insight into it, then please feel free to comment below and then we can all learn, okay? So let's get started with that first. And then afterwards, I will share with you guys a little bit more about what's going on in my life, okay? Okay, 咁頭先我講咗，今日係27號，咁上個星期一20號係我媽咪生日，咁我媽咪今年82歲，82，咁佢其實佢唔似82歲，佢我諗係因為佢嗰啲皮膚，啲皮膚好靚，我媽咪嗰啲皮膚好靚，咁我諗我可以 post 個 picture 喺度 ，and then 你哋自己可以睇下。And then comment below, 你告訴我你覺得我媽咪似幾多歲，不過真的她今年是82，她1938年出世，因為其實通常生日你都會，即我們都會打電話給她，講生日快樂，身體健康，我想大家都知道我有很多兄弟姊妹，我有10個兄弟姊妹，第一個呢就 Sheila， 第二個是 Anita， 第三個 Deidre， 第四個 Carla， 第五個是我啦，阿蕭，第六個是 Liz， 第七個是 Patty， 第八個是 Mary， 第九個是 Kathy， 第十個是 Ted， and 第十一個是 John。 咁 I'm gonna take a little break there first because if you notice I was using the numbersBut I had a prefix before it that turned the number into an ordinal number, meaning first, second, third, fourth, in my long list of brothers and sisters, right? So that prefix is the low tone, dai, dai. And so, for example, if you want to say first, you'd be saying dai yat, right? Dai high tone yat, dai yat, dai yi, dai san, dai se, dai m. Okay, so all of that is simply how to make it into first, second, third. It's super simple. You just need to add that prefix. It's not like in English where we have a different word for first, second, and third before we get to the th, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, like that. So that's a little bit of Cantonese for you there. Oh, I forgot one thing, and that is that I remember when I was learning Cantonese and I learned the dai yat, dai yi, dai san, and dai yat is first, right? So I always thought it was kind of weird that then when you went to take first class, for example, if you were on Star Ferry and they have a first class section. Or if you were taking the East Rail, which before was just the KCR, the train, it was, they always have that one carriage, which is the first class carriage. But I never saw that they had the character for yet, which is just yawa, right? It's just like a horizontal line for the number one. And I thought that's so weird, because first you would expect to see that the yet, but no, when you're talking about first class, it's a completely different construction. Instead of saying the yet class or the echo class, they say tao dang, right? It's completely different. It's tao dang, the low falling tao, and then your mid rising dang. So tao dang is how to say first class. But what does it mean? So your tao is your head, all right? So head, you can imagine, is the top, tao, and then your dang. Actually, you probably know that dang from wait a moment, right? It's like dang yatsan, dang yatang, dang dang, dang yatsan is all to say wait a moment, right? So that dang, you probably, if you've been learning Cantonese, know that that means wait. And the same character, same tone, also has the meaning of a grade or a rank. So if you are the tao dang, you are the head of the class, head of the rank, right? And that is how you say first class. So if you were wondering that, or were thinking that you were going to say, oh, I'm taking the diaco class, that class, I suppose people would know what you mean, but you will more often, well, you should properly say tao dang. So now back to a little bit more, I'll share a little bit more with you about what's been going on my mom's birthday. So, omami sanya goya, and while they say all of my brothers and sisters, and it's stupid, but my mom and my mommy, they will keep a list. They will write who is the first one, who is the first one, the second one, the third one, and so on. Every year, we want to, like a competition, we want to try who can be the first one, who can be the first one, who can be the first one. 很多年來都不是我做第一, 因為, 可能是因為我通常在香港打理, 那個時差 is 很大, 其實是14個小時, 那現在呢, 我在, 你, 大家都知道我在美國, 那就, 那個problem不是很大, 那我呢, 就在, 東岸, 我在, East Coast, 那我們比我媽咪就快一個小時, 一個鐘, So yeah, so like if you're saying 1 hour, 一個鐘 is 1 hour. But 有時, sometimes you'll hear people say 一個小時. So 小時 is also another way to say hour. So if you hear that, then that means the same thing as 一個鐘, 一個鐘頭, 一個小時 is 1 hour. So 我媽咪嗰度, 我媽咪住喺, 威士康辛州, Wisconsin. So 佢, 即係我哋係快佢一個鐘. So I was the first one, and 我是排第一, 打給我媽咪, so yay me, 恭喜, 我是第一個打給我媽咪, 我沒試過, 真的很多年來我都沒試過, 排第一. So anyway, that was my big claim to fame this month, is I was first. And I know that seems kind of lame and stupid, but, because the trick is you can't call too early, right? 如果你太早打理, 他當然在睡覺, 他就沒那麼開心, and 當然他生日那天來上去開心. So yeah, that's what's been going on. The big excitement has been my mom's birthday, but being sad that we can't be there to celebrate with her, but hopefully soon, you know, we'll be able to travel more again, and I'll be able to travel back to Hong Kong. So that's pretty much the story for a lot of people, has been how to travel during this time. And I was all set to go back to Hong Kong in the beginning of July when United, American, and Delta started flying again. Not that I have anything against other airlines, but I've always been Star Alliance, and it just made sense to wait since things were pretty bad in Hong Kong to start with, and then they were getting a lot better. So around May, we started going back to work. As you guys know, I have a job as well, but I'm fortunate enough that I can work from home. And although I need to stay up all night just to match Hong Kong hours, I just feel so fortunate to be able to continue working even though I'm not there. So in the beginning, it wasn't a problem because everyone was working from home. And then in May, people started going back into the office, first in shifts and then back completely as normal. And so then it was like, okay, I need to get back. And United started flying again beginning of July. So I booked my ticket originally for the 8th, which was a Wednesday. And then I thought better of it. And I thought, well, if anything goes wrong, it's the middle of the work week. I'm going to change it to the weekend, fly on a Saturday, arrive back in Hong Kong on a Sunday. And that way there'll be the least amount of disturbance to my job. So they started flying on the 6th, and by the 8th, United had canceled again because Hong Kong, as you know, if you've been following the news, has been experiencing the third wave now of the coronavirus infection. And a lot of people, over 100, are being diagnosed every day. They're trying to plug up all the loopholes. And so the American carriers, immediately stopped flying because one of these loopholes was the pilots and the air crew who were not really required to test. They were allowed to come into Hong Kong, and then for their layover time, a day to whatever it was, they were pretty much free to do whatever they wanted. The same was true for people coming in on ships, crews that are on the freighters that come into Hong Kong. So the same, that was kind of a big loophole they were trying to plug. So come the 7th, I think the 8th of July, they plugged that up by saying that if you fly into Hong Kong, you also need to be tested. If you're a pilot or a flight attendant or any kind of crew, and if you're positive, then of course you need to do quarantine because you're actually going, yeah, that basically was it. So the logistics were such that a lot of airlines now cannot fly into Hong Kong. I know Emirates as well. KLM, I think, is doing something through Bangkok where they fly international to Bangkok and then they change their crew. So it's more of a local crew flying the short haul flight. But the long haul flights from the States have all been stopped. So my flight on the 8th was, no, sorry, I moved it from the 8th to the 18th, which was a Saturday. That got canceled. At the time they told me, oh, we'll just book again for the 20th. And I was like, yeah, that's not going to happen. So I actually ended up booking my ticket for August 1st. And today I got an email and a call saying, well, that's been canceled. So now I'm waiting to see when they'll be going back. In the meantime, Cathay Pacific, Hong Kong's airline, is flying back to Hong Kong from the United States. But Hong Kong's just made it more difficult now to even do that because of the requirement to have a COVID test and the result within 72 hours of flying. Plus, instead of just being called on the phone to be told that, hey, you know, you tested negative, you're okay, everything's fine, you need to actually have a letter stating that you are a negative test, and also that a letter stating that the place that where you had the test done was a legitimate testing center. So there's another layer of security there that you did the test properly, it was negative, then you can board. Another thing that they put in, which may not be as big of a deal because a lot of people are already doing it, but people from high-risk countries, of which the United States now is a high-risk country in the eyes of Hong Kong, which is why that change came about getting the COVID test. So if you are in a different country flying in, you don't need to have a test unless your country is on that high-risk list, which the United States from the 27th. Yeah, I think so. It's the Wednesday of the week. I get confused because they instituted it, I think, on Wednesday at like Tuesday night going into Wednesday at midnight. But as you know, if you fly from the States, you've got to leave that one day time difference gap. So you pretty much had to leave on Monday if you wanted to make it in before the deadline. So on top of the test and the letter saying the test is legit, you have to quarantine in hotel, mandatory, and you have to pay for that. So even if you live alone and you have your own flat, you're not allowed to go back to your flat until you've completed 2 weeks quarantine in a hotel. So the pressure was on for a lot of people to change their flights and get in before that deadline, but it didn't seem to make a lot of sense nor be very responsible to do that because Hong Kong's going through a major crisis right now and hospital beds are pretty full up. So if there is no real need to get back, then why would you do it just to meet that deadline? I really don't understand. I respect the fact that that's what some people feel they had to do, but for me, that wasn't going to happen because everyone's working from home now anyway. I'm able to work from home. It's a small price to pay to stay up all night and like work the night shift. And so that's where I am. But I am waiting to get back. I want to get back, but it's more of a case to me to respect the system. If that's the what's been going on there, then, you know, I'm fortunate enough that I have a place to stay here. I know a lot of people, well, I think a lot of people that didn't or don't were getting themselves back, you know, as soon as they could anyway. So that's pretty much what's been going on. We've moved house. I'm in a new little Cantonese corner. So I'm very happy about that. The weather here is beautiful. It's summertime. Where I am, it's not like in total lockdown, and it's not completely reopened, as things are completely as normal, but it's pretty okay. I mean, everyone wears masks. Everyone is being responsible. There hasn't been a lot of some of the upheaval that you see in other cities. I'm not near where that's going on. So for the time being, pretty happy to stay put and stay right where I am. So I hope this has been maybe a little bit interesting stuff to share with you about what's been going on. I hope you find the Cantonese helpful. And until next time, take care wherever you are. And if you, again, want to learn Cantonese with me, I'll be back over at cantolingo.com. Otherwise, I will see you again next time here on my little Cantonese corner. Take care, everyone. Bye.